Thank you very much, Tash. Thank you very much to everyone. A special thanks to Carmen Martinez, who is the one in charge of this presentation. So I'm going to present the innovation in mental health services in Colombia on behalf of MSF Ogba. So then let's move to Colombia's map to see just quick about the context. So this is a Colombia map, and those are the three regions where MSF is working right now. This is the region where I'm going to present today. This is Buenaventura urban area. As we can see here, this is close to the sea, and that means that it's the main port of Colombia. 60% of the legal business is ongoing through Buenaventura, which means that for the mafia guys, let's say, it is quite interesting to be here in order to take the control. And then it's quite tough to the population because they use several heavy issues against the population, like killing and this and that. And especially sometimes they have a very difficult restriction movement. So this is the reason why MSF is developing this kind of program here in Buenaventura. Okay, this is some of the figures about also context in Buenaventura. But then before that, let's say that 90% of the population in Buenaventura are Afro-Colombian people. 60% of them are living under poverty or line. So as we can see here, we have 42% of them has been displaced, and 48% are victims of the conflict. In Colombia, there is a conflict ongoing, and there are certain regions where the violence is becoming very higher and increasing every day, let's say, like in Buenaventura. And this is another figure which is speaking about the context. We have homicides case rate per 100 inhabitants is 41, which is the double compared with the national statistics. Just here, just to speak a bit, this is more about MSF is getting information about the context. And this one, bodies, non-legal grounds. This one is quite tough. This is a national people who take these statistics, and we bring these statistics for us. This is 19 cases, but 19 cases doesn't mean that they found 19 bodies. It means that they found 19 holes with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 bodies, or just piece of bodies. So this is Buenaventura context. So why MSF is there? Because the violence, but also people has very heavy restriction to movements by times. Okay, so this is Buenaventura again. What we are doing in Buenaventura? We are providing therapeutic counseling through the cell phone and face-to-face sessions. So as we can see here, this is A, B, and C. What does it mean? It means that these are the physical rooms where MSF is providing the therapeutic as well, face-to-face with psychologists. And the call center is working in this area as well. So somebody is calling us, the psychologist pick up the phone, and they start either through the phone or referral the case through one of these places. We will speak later about when we referral cases to those three rooms. Something else to say that this area is one of the tougher ones, so this is why we have this kind of signals that we promote the service through the radio, but also our cars used to go here to promote as well the service. Which kind of service are we providing there? Mental health and psychosocial support. And for the acute psychiatric cases, we refer to the presential ABC room with our doctors. And also integrate medical care, no, with sexual violence cases. So our doctors used to see and to treat patients as well in sexual violence cases. Okay, so it's an innovative strategy for us. Why? Because MSF didn't develop this before, and in the context it's also new. It's working 24 hours and all the days in a week by a multidisciplinary team, as already mentioned, psychologists, social workers, and medical doctors. And it's, again, tele-counselling via cell phone or face-to-face. Target population, people with emotional symptoms relating to the violence, sexual violence, and acute psychiatric cases. Okay, so what we want to answer and why I am here today. The strategy is trying to see if that new model is increases the more population, especially when there is a movement restriction. So if we have more people using that the cell phone, let's say. But also we are going to go in deep and analyze a bit more about the clinical outcomes. It's not a matter only to having more people, but it's also a matter of quality of the care. Okay, so to answer the question about the access, we will go in the, with the data from February to December, before the program started and after the program started. But about the clinical outcomes, we will be focused only from September to December. The results. So in total, it's not here, but in total we received from September to December when the program started around 10,000 calls. But we were able just to speak with 7,000 something. But out of 7,451, we have to remove the technical problems and people who, you know, funny talks or prank talks or whatever. So we will be focused just in the 43% remaining. Now, target population from this 43%, it was 23% who calling us. Target follow-ups is 36%, but that follow-up is not only to do the session with the psychologist in the phone, it's also to ask for the address in the ABC rooms. Other service requests is 12%. What does it mean? It means that as a medical organization, people used to call us for medical check-in. So what is important for the psychologist is to do a properly assessment to see if that medical question is linked with psychosomatic complaint, for example. Otherwise, we keep the session. If not, we refer to the medical service, not to the national. And non-target calls is people who were having mental health complaints, but that mental health complaints is not relating with the violence, not sexual violence neither. Okay, patients. We have here 732, but we will be focused just in 565 because the rest were, they knew the program through different strategies, not through the radio. So we'll be focused just in 65. And in the call, we will keep in only 67%. Why? Because those 33%, we were referral, and that is important. Which are the criteria for us to referral to the physical room? Okay, sexual violence, because it's an emergency situation. Psychiatric acute cases, somebody who perhaps is wanting to kill himself or want to kill another one. And people who are scared to speak are also in the phone, so they prefer to speak face to face. So those are the more or less the three referral situations when we referral to the presential, let's say. Then in the call, so at the beginning we keep 378, but then later on we have to referral as well, more or less almost half of them, no, by more or less the same reasons. Okay, speaking about gender and age, we have almost 70% of the population who call us are female, and most of them are more than 19 years old. The diagnosis, just to say that the diagnosis, we follow the criteria about the DCM-40 and R. These are the psychologists who do the diagnosis, so I'm not going to speak about that because he's already there. And clinical outcomes, which is quite important also. We closed from September to December 372 cases. And, okay, here I have it. Okay, so reason for ending treatment. What does it mean? It means that when we start the evaluation, we do also a planned treatment with the client in order to achieve some goals. So if we achieve the goals, we call successful treatment, right? Now, sometimes, because the severe of the symptoms could be low symptoms or moderate, it will be just a single consultation, but also because people have to move or they say that, you know, I cannot come back or I can't call you back or whatever is the reason. So we do also single consultation as well. Dropout means that the people who are not coming back anymore for us, neither through the phone, neither face to face. But however, we try to reach them. How? Perhaps calling them, perhaps asking to the family member, you know, how is your peeing, what's going on, to see what is happening. And then patient referral, we have here 29%. Most of them has been referred from the call center, means that from the phone, to the face-to-face. 106 cases, more or less, were referral. Now, we have a big dropout, no? So people are not coming back anymore. So this is one thing that we are going to speak a bit more. Now, condition and exit means that how people, if despite they don't come back, how they finish the treatment. Perhaps we have here people who improve. Even they didn't come back. For example, from this successful treatment, no? So they didn't come back, but they improved. Or from the dropout, they didn't come back, no? So even we didn't close, let's say, in the agreement with the client, sometimes they improve their symptoms using the scales rate. Okay, so impossible to determine is almost 53%. Most of them are here, right? From those who are drop out are this figure. Okay, so we have 258 clients who have been treated through the call center and 114 from the face-to-face. Just about the speaking about the this unable to trace, no? We have that 81% has been treated through the call center, 18% to face-to-face. What does it mean? It means that we are having very challenging in the call center about the dropout and about the improvement as well, as we can see here, no? So the improvement is higher in the face-to-face, is 68%. In the call center, is just 27%. Okay, admissions. This is to answer the question about is this innovative model is really trying more people, no? Yeah, having more people. So the call center started in September, and we want to compare before and after. So before, we were having 60 new clients per month, on average. And after the new project started, the new model started is 171, which means that it's really increasing at 186%. So we are having more people with the new program. Conclusions. So we are having this innovative model is helping the people for the access when they have movement restrictions. And the call center is also another way to provide treatment for the population as well. Now, clinical findings, we have to analyze much better and go in deeply, but keep in mind that this is also a very new, it was just 4 months which we are analyzing. It's not to avoid the discussion, but it's just to mention that, okay, even though we have to keep in mind and to consider that we are having some challenge in the closure, especially in the call center. Recommendation, the model could be in places where MSF is seeing that population has restriction movements, but, and this is very much important, it's not only that people are not able to move, has to be in a very safe place, otherwise we put people at risk as well, and perhaps they are not going to call in, no? If they feel that calling us is very tricky and very risky for them, they are not calling, and the model is not going to work, neither. And we already speak about the reasons behind dropout, and we have to improve perhaps our protocols, our skills as a psychologist, in order to avoid the high right dropout in the call center. I guess this is all.